Hey guys, so last week I picked up a few beauty products at Sephora, just one item at Sephora, one item at the drugstore, and one item at MAC, which is kind of like a staple to my makeup collection from MAC, which you guys could all probably guess. It's just a Studio Fix foundation, but I'll still share that with you. And I also just picked up two pairs of boots that I thought I'd just include in this little mini beauty product haul that I got for the fall season. So I thought they were kind of cute. I thought I'd share that with you guys. Hopefully you guys are all having a great weekend. So I'll start off with what I picked up at Sephora. I had a gift card because if you guys follow me on Twitter, I had to exchange my NARS. What shade did I get from NARS? My NARS matte foundation, I did not like it. And it made me break out, so I was like, oh, it's like $42. I had to exchange it for something, and it took me a long time to decide what I wanted. And since the Naked palette from Urban Decay sold out like that, I couldn't get that. And I tried a few Sephora's actually. So about a month later, which was last weekend, so I decided to just pick up the Too Faced Natural Eye Neutral Eyeshadow Collection. And it looks like that. You guys probably have all seen this around YouTube, floating around videos about this. I absolutely love this. I'm actually wearing it on my eyes right now. And this attempt is actually the Fashion Eye. Just in case you guys didn't know, it comes with three different cards. So it's got the Fashion, the Day, and the Classic Neutral Eye. And it just comes, and you can put that back in this little slot area right there. And it comes in a little magnetic box that you can open up. It's very convenient, and I thought it was really cute. They had the Smoky Eye one, and I forgot the other color that they had. There are the other box collection that they had, but I absolutely love neutrals. For the day look, you would use the Velvet Revolver, the Sexpresso, and the Heaven. And then for the classic look, you would use the Silk Teddy, Push Up, and Erotica. I know they're very promiscuous type of rated R names, I think, but that's Too Faced. Too Faced and Benefit kind of have that going on, as well as NARS, as you guys all know, if you guys are all into the whole name thing. The fashion one uses Nude Beach, Honey Pot, and Cocoa Puff. And this is the one that I attempted to do today. I love it. Look at these colors. They're absolutely pigmented. And on the back of it, it tells you a little snippet of how do I create a natural eye. There's a guy right there. I guess he's the founder. Gerard Blandino, Too Faced founder, natural eye expert. Ooh, fancy. So this is that. It's really cute. I really, really love it. It's $32 or $38. I think it was $38. Well, actually, I do have the receipt right here. Beauty Insider sale, blah, blah, blah. Oh, it was $35. So $38.06 total from Sephora. And, ooh, I gotta do this. Tell us what you think. Take our survey to enter and enter to win a $250 gift card at Sephora. Yay. I gotta do that. You never know, right? So that's all I got from Sephora, just the Too Faced Natural Eye, which I love because it comes with, let's see, 9 eyeshadows for $35. That's amazing. And it actually, when you pull this little drawer out, it does come with, I haven't even used it, it's like the angle brush and the sponge applicator, which I'll probably just leave in here just in case I carry it around. But it's a really good travel kit too, so when you are going on vacation and you just don't plan to use a lot of colors on your eyeshadows at that time, or if you're going to travel for work, or you know, staying somewhere for the weekend, I think this is such a convenient palette to bring. So once again, it's got like the very gorgeous colors for your brow bones and for your inner eyelid, your outer eyelid, or your creases, however you want to mix it up. You don't have to follow these, you know, helpful little cards that are actually really helpful for those of you that are just beginning with makeup. I think they're really helpful, but you don't have to follow that. I think you can create your own look. You can mix it up however you want. Obviously, you don't have to follow that. So I'm just gonna put this back. So you put it in here like so, and you slide it in just like that, and it comes in like a magnetic. It's just so convenient. I don't know, maybe I'll pick up the other ones. It depends. I pretty much just gravitated to this one because I love my neutrals and the colors. Since I was craving for the eye palette, and I still am, If anyone knows anything about the eye palettes or when they're gonna come back, I've heard rumors of when, but if someone actually has seen them around somewhere in California, you know, San Diego, LA area, please let me know. I even looked on Craigslist for people selling them. It's ridiculous. So, but look at the colors. They remind me of the Naked palette colors. I think for some of them, even though I know I've never actually seen the Naked palette, I think they're very comparable. So that's why I probably picked this one up right away, since I wanted the Naked palette so bad. I was like, oh, I'm on a mission. I'm going to find it. And I didn't, obviously, last week. So I just had to pick up this one. But enough about this one. The other thing that I picked up at Bloomingdale's, I just went to the MAC counter there. I hate going to Bloomingdale's because there's so many amazing and beautiful things I want to buy there but can't afford to. So, yeah, that sucks. But it's still a lot of fun going there, seeing all these amazing makeup lines. You know, Chanel's there, Louis Vuitton's there. It's just an awesome place. I think I love Bloomingdale's. But I just picked up my NC35. I usually go in between NC35, NC40. I mix it up once in a while. So this time I was low on my NC40. So I decided to pick up another NC35, which you can never go. I can never have enough of. So that is that. It's just my Studio Fix foundation, which I love using this. If I, like, today I'm wearing Chanel Pro Lumiere on my face as a foundation, but I set it with this. But when I'm in a hurry in the morning, going to work, whatnot, this is the only thing that I pretty much put on, and it goes on flawlessly. It gives you such great coverage. It makes you look extremely gorgeous, I think. I mean, if you apply it well enough where, you know, it can cover up the right areas of your skin. It's a great must-have and a staple to my collection because it's just a great in a hurry type of thing where you don't have to apply foundation. It applies on and covers perfectly as if you had applied foundation under it, liquid foundation. So just don't pack it on too much or don't reapply it too much for the day. And that's another thing I think is that I like it because I don't have to retouch it up during the day. Obviously, you can blot a little bit or use a flat top or a buffer kabuki brush to just touch up during the day, but you don't want to pack it on because it's gonna seem too heavy and cakey, especially if you have oily combination skin. It seems, from my experience, when I've done that, I was like, oh my gosh, I came home and I'm like, oh, my face looks so muddy and like too much gunk or too much makeup layers. So you'd never want to do that. Typically, when you apply it on early in the morning, it will last about 10 hours. So I love the Studio Fix foundation from MAC. Can never not have it in my makeup collection or in my purse. The last makeup product or beauty product that I picked up that weekend was the Maybelline New York, the Falsies Volume Express Mascara, which looks like that. This one is black as black. Here's the brush. That's what it looks like. It has like fiber. It reminds me of an old MAC mascara that I have with the fibers, you know, to make it look, to add a little bit of fiber onto your lashes. I think that's what it's supposed to do because I can see it right there. I'm not in love with it, so I've only used it 3 times. Sometimes with mascaras, I know you guys probably can relate to this. It takes a while. It takes a few days or maybe even a week for us to really get that consistency that we like out of the tube. So maybe that's how it is with this product, but I wasn't, honestly, I've never really been a fan of Maybelline mascaras. I love my L'Oreal Volume Express. I love my Black is Black, my Volume Express, my Voluminous from L'Oreal. And I still wanna try the Millions mascara one, the new Millions Voluminous, whatever it is from L'Oreal, and the really pretty shiny tube. But my Voluminous mascara in Carbon Black and Black is Black also is one of my favorite all-time mascaras. Of course, you're always going to want to try different mascaras that we see in commercials on YouTube and they brand out there. But this one wasn't like, oh my gosh, love at first sight. So I picked this up because a few of my friends on Vlog TV recommended it. I'm wearing it right now, but I don't feel like it gives me that volume. I feel like it becomes too clumpy and I have to apply so much layers. And that's just me. It's probably because of my lashes. Everyone has a different opinion and everyone has different lashes, obviously. But this is an okay product for now. We'll see how it goes in a few weeks. Then I'll probably report back to you guys with another review on it a little bit more. But moving on to other things, other funner things such as fashion, I picked up 2 boots like I told you guys. The first one is this pair right here, which is a regular black kind of, what is this, fake suede material that is a slouchy boot. So it has a zipper that goes all the way down like so. And the funny thing is, this is actually in size 4 in girls. So since I have pretty small feet, I got about a $10 discount off of this. Not a discount, obviously, but I saved $10 because I shopped at the girls selection. There is a boutique called Shoe Galaxy near my house, and they sell all kinds of like men's shoes, women's shoes, kid shoes. So the lady was so helpful. She helped me find them in my size, or my size in girls, which is size 4, 3 and 4, but 4 is more comfortable, especially in boots. So I got that. And these go perfect with tights and with skinny jeans. You can wear them pretty much with shorts, with like short shorts if it's kind of like a okay type of day where you can wear shorts and boots depending on, you know, what you're doing that day. It's definitely a staple to have, I think, black slouchy boots or gray slouchy boots in your shoe collection or in your wardrobe. So the other one I was kind of hesitant to buy because I know I probably didn't need this, but I do love this color. It reminds me of fall a lot, just because, I don't know, it's more neutral. And again, with the neutrals, it's kind of like that taupey color, and it's from a shoe line called Bamboo right there. This one is actually in my size, which is size 6. I'm a 5.5 and 6 in women. So I love it because it's got that cuff right there. It's got the zipper like so, and it's got a little kitten heel like that, which isn't too much or doesn't look too funky. It's just perfect the way I would like to wear it. And it has the like strap around like that, as you guys can see, with the studs and buckles. And you guys all know how crazy I am about studs and buckles or anything like that. So I thought that was a really cute touch to a pair of boots, so I just had to have it. But yeah, maybe I will show it to you guys and try to incorporate it in an outfit of the day pretty soon when I have time. I've been kind of lazy with outfit of the days. But anyways, that's about it, guys. I hope you guys all have an amazing weekend. I'll try to upload this as soon as I can. And yeah, oh, look what I found at the gas station. Extra Dessert Delights sugar-free gum and key lime pie. Amazing. So highly recommend it if you guys see this. Just thought I'd share that with you guys. Have a good day, guys, and I'll see you guys very soon. Bye.